of the self-proclaimed, but most famous comedian in Zimbabwe.
No.
What do you call, what is
I am, the biggest Zimbabwean stand-up comedian in the world.
One more time so all the other comedians hear this.
Yeah, I am the biggest Zimbabwean stand-up comedian in the world.
In the world.
There's comedians who are the best Zimbabwean comedians.
Mm-hmm.
That's not me.
You're just the biggest.
I'm the biggest, no, Zimbabwean stand-up comedian in the world.
Okay.
You can be the biggest one in Zim.
But in the world,
indeed. In the world, I'm the biggest one. I've got the biggest market share. I'm just...
You're just the biggest.
I'm just the biggest
one. Okay. All right. Carl Joshua Ncube in the building. Tell me about Mexico. I think a lot of people want to hear about Mexico. You did a trip to Mexico. What was that all about?
Wow. So after I did a TED Talk in, in Edinburgh this year, there's a festival that's called the Festival of Bright Ideas. So basically they bring a collection of all the brightest minds to just talk about what they're doing.
And they chose you.
Yeah,
did they not have my number?
Yeah, I know, right? I mean, I know. And you know what was weird? What was weird is I saw this thing in the hotel room that talked about, you know, thank you so much for joining us. I think what they were saying is that my narrative about Zimbabwe mm-hmm. was just different to everyone else. It made them want to know more about Zimbabwe,
okay.
about investment opportunities, about context. Why am I so positive about the country?
Right.
That's what they wanted to get.
So what is that reason? Let's unpack that real quick.
You're right. I mean, the thing is, like, it's well documented that there's, you know, the economy is in the state that it's in,
mm-hmm.
right? But what's not well documented is what the successes are.
Okay.
And I think it's...
I told you about my success, Acho.
Yeah.
Okay. I told you about my successes.
Yeah, yeah. I think there's a lot of successes.
Okay.
I live in Victoria Falls. I see the tourism inflows.
Yeah.
I see how the tourists are looking at where the exchange rate is and why things are now cheaper for them. So when you come in with your Forex,
yes.
Zimbabwe is now more competitive than South Africa because our currency is pegged slightly weaker than the rand.
Okay.
So it makes a lot of things cheaper when tourists are coming into the country.
Mm-hmm.
And I've seen this over the year because when people came at the beginning of the year, I've seen the same people come in like later on in the year.
Okay.
And they've said themselves that things have become cheaper.
Mm.
Right? So,
but that's those who are coming in. Core, very based locally. How do you feel they are taking it within the falls themselves?
It's difficult, right?
Yeah.
It's difficult. I think Victoria Falls is a special place
because
I think people to some extent were also earning foreign currency. Victoria Falls is very different to, say, Harare because everyone is pretty much employed in Victoria Falls.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone is doing something, but everyone has access to foreign markets. They can go into Zambia, they can go into Botswana.
Mm-hmm.
It's just kind of a model that's a bit different. The game changer was the airport.
Okay.
It's bringing us in more people. So, for example, even from a comedy perspective,
mm-hmm.
I don't do comedy shows where I charge at the door. I now pass around a bucket and people actually...
So I'm not going to donate it.
Yeah, you know, so people pay a tip rather than
right.
me charging at the door.
Okay.
That's because I don't need to advertise. People literally are there in Victoria Falls all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It gives you a couple of insights as well. Like you've seen, like the trains are now coming in, they're packed into Victoria Falls. So NRZ
yes.
is doing very well from that perspective.
Mm-hmm.
Signaling has changed a bit. The trains are arriving on time. You know, like Air Zimbabwe, for example, is also filling up, which is great.
Nice.
They're also in a very compromised state, but these are kind of things that you're seeing as like successes. You can see if we move.
These are tangible successes on the ground.
I think so. And,
okay.
I, and I think there's an extra step that now needs to be done, though. I think on a personal level, people now need to be working in a more sustainable, living in sustainable ways.
Okay.
So, for example, community gardens, you know, considering like homeschooling, things like that,
mm-hmm.
You know, ways in which you can sort of mitigate the effects of what the economy is doing to us at the moment.
Pretty dope, man. Carl Joshua Ncube in studio on the rush today.
Yeah.
We're discussing his forays into the international arena, invitations he's been getting, TED Talks, tequila tasting. There's a lot. There's a lot that's been going on. And I keep mentioning this tequila. I really hope you brought some back.
Yeah.
For now.
I did.
Yes. Excellent. Let's get into what we've got in terms of your choices for the Rush Drive-Thru today. Let's hear about it.
Hello, Zimbabwe. My name is Prophet. I mean, comic pastor from Facebook International Ministries. You're watching ZFM Stereo, my station, your station where your miracles happen. Do pacho ipapo, ramba mchiwona, mchikomborerwa, ne ZFM TV. I mean, ZFM Stereo. This is also ZFM.
books. He's done stand-up comedy outside the country, in the country as well. But you've done something a little bit out of that sphere.
Right,
you did a documentary, or you've been on the road within Zimbabwe doing a documentary.
Yeah.
Tell us a bit about that.
Okay, so we went on this documentary to look at how we can sustainably like look after our wildlife and that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
But the issue was to look at the human story, kind of get context. It's great to have a stand-up comedy because that's how I do my research, right?
Yeah.
I go talk to people, then I convert those stories into humor.
Mm-hmm.
But wow, what an insightful trip, because just going around the country and just seeing, because the narrative is that black Zimbabweans are poor and that's why they get into poaching, but that was not the story I saw.
Mm-hmm.
I saw Zimbabweans that really actually care about the environment. People who are like, elephants are destroying their crops, lions are killing their kids, but at the same time they're like, no, we will not touch these animals because they're very important to our livelihood.
Okay.
There's a reason why people come into, in fact there's one community like in Guanarejo where they noticed the elephants, they pass through their village going to Mozambique, and the poachers then kill the elephants, and then less elephants sort of come back.
Right.
So they decided, they're working with NGOs and that kind of thing, decided to actually fence off more land in their own community that they could have used for farming and used it for elephants instead, increasing the size of Guanarejo because they also want to get into ecotourism and that kind of thing.
Okay.
So it was so insane, like even seeing how the fishermen, like you know, are using nets with bigger sort of bigger gauge sort of nets,
okay,
to allow the smaller fish to come
swim
out
through.
And they don't mind right now that they're not making any money at the moment, but they've seen an increase in the fish that they've, you know. And these are all community-based things, and NGOs are coming and supporting it, the government is supporting it, parks is supporting it, so it's so incredible and a privilege to actually get around the country and see some of this stuff happening. It's given me a lot of hope.
How long did this take you?
Wow, I mean, we traveled around the country for about 2 months, you know, kind of on and off.
Mm.
Most of it sort of a sustained trip going, because we went from the top of Zimbabwe right down to the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And man, went through Lupane on the ferry in Kariba. Then we, you know, it was just insane.
Yeah.
It was incredible.
So your take home from this entire process?
I think the public or citizens have a lot more power than they think they do.
Okay.
Especially to effect meaningful change in their own lives.
Mm.
I think what it is the lessons that I've learned is that people working together can actually achieve more. So for example, some of the lessons that I've taken, like this, these ladies that were these nuts that they're called manketi nuts that are used in cosmetics.
Okay.
And, you know, this product is going straight from Lupane and going straight out the country, right?
Wow.
And these ladies get together and they're doing this work, and it's like, it's super incredible.
Mm.
There's bee projects that are there where people are keeping bees to keep the elephants from coming into their village, but then they're making money from the honey.
Yeah.
And it's...
Self-sustenance, basically.
Yeah, but if I saw this happening in urban areas, I think that would be... For me, like a first prize. If I started seeing community gardens, like people, you know, growing vegetables in their own sort of spheres, maybe sharing one borehole, maybe using community centers to augment sort of education and that kind of thing. Going to the tiny house sort of
scenario. Yes,
like for example, I converted a bus that I got for free,
yep,
which was being thrown away, and converted it into a house. Perhaps maybe we need to start changing the way that we're living. Perhaps we can save the environment a little bit more.
How do we follow your journey, Carl? Let us know your social media handles, all of that, so that we know where exactly to find you on the internet.
Cool. So firstly, the documentary, which is quite interesting, you can find on afronet.com.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can look at all of the stuff that I'm doing on Carl Joshua Ncube, which is on Instagram, on Facebook.
Mm-hmm.
With the Alternative Home Sweet Home, which also talks about the sustainability, so you can also see the links to the documentary as well.
Fantastic.
Yeah, but pretty much just follow anything to do with the biggest Zimbabwean stand-up comedian in the world.
At Carl Joshua Ncube.
Yes.
Man, we love it, man. Thank you for coming through today, man. It's been a minute. I'm glad you got to hang out with
us
today.
Thank you for the Boys to Men.
Yes.
And thank you for the OK adverts. I love their aircon. I'm like a connoisseur of their aircon. I think they have probably the best aircon of any supermarket in the country.
And
sometimes I just walk in just for the
air conditioner.
I just stand by the fridges and everything. I'll let
Tendai know that we've got an avid fan of their air conditioning in the OK store.
Absolutely.
So boys, we're good. Keep it up. OK Zim. Carl Joshua, have a great one, man. We'll talk again real soon.
Cool.
Take
Fantastic.
It easy, bruv.
Hi guys, my name is Doc Vikela. You're watching ZFM Stereo, my station, your station. Yeah.